Hello dear student, in the lesson of understanding quadrilateral we will focus on the concept of rhombus, rectangle and the square also. So let's get started. So in the case of rhombus, as you observe the figure, so here to obtain rhombus as a special case of kite, and you observe this diagram of rhombus, here same symbol is there. It means that all the sides of rhombus are same, these all sides are equal. And in the case of kite, you see the adjacent sides are same. This side is same as this one is this one. And here in the kite, this angle is same as this one. Opposite angle, only one pair is same. And in the case of rhombus, this angle will be same as this one. And here one more angle, this one is same as this one. So opposite angle both are same. And these are the diagonal, they bisect each other perpendicularly, means here they will make the angle of 90 degree in every case, and they divide this into equal part. It means that they bisect, means this side will be same as this one from distance from the center. From here to here this side will be same as from here to here it will be same. So this is the concept of rhombus. And note that the side of rhombus are all of the same length that we already discussed. Now rhombus is a quadrilateral with all sides of equal length. Since the opposite sides of rhombus have the same, these opposite sides are same as well as angles are also same, so it means it can be parallelogram. It is definitely a parallelogram. It is kite also, because the opposite angles are same. Okay, and these sides, adjacent sides are also same, so it is satisfying the criteria of kite also. So rhombus is a kite as well as parallelogram. This is very important point. So the most useful property of rhombus is that the diagonals are perpendicular bisector. We have seen in the parallelogram the diagonals are there, but they are not perpendicular bisector. So for justifying this property, we will take a proof here. Rhombus, it is a parallelogram too, so diagonal bisect each other. It means this OD equal to same as OB and AO is same as OC, and we have to show the angle of 90 degree, that is DOA is 90 degree, DOC is 90 degree. That angle we have to show here according to this statement. So here we have to apply side property in two triangle. You can take the triangle DOA and DOC, we can take the this pair also. Okay, so as we are taking this pair, they are the congruent angle. Why it is congruent? Because this side is same as this one, because diagonal bisect. So it means this side is same as this one in the triangle. This is also same, because in rhombus all the sides are same, so DC is same as AD, and this one is common side. So according to the property of side and side, these two triangles are concurrent, and therefore this angle O, means DOA and DOC, they are equal and they are the linear angle, they are in one line, so they should break in two equal parts. So linear angle means 180 angle they make, straight line angle. If you divide in two equal part, ultimately they will be equal, means 90 degree. So this is the concept. So it means that diagonal, they bisect each other, and the important point is they are the perpendicular bisector, because they are making 90 degree angle. Here if you take the rhombus and find the value of xyz, it is quite easy. You can solve this in a few seconds. All sides are same, so z will be 13, because the measurement of one side is 13. Diagonal, they bisect each other, so this side is 12, this side will be 12, here it is 5, so x will be 5. So here you can solve, because the diagonal bisect, so here the value of OE is 5, I already explained. Value of X is 12 and the Z will be 13, because all sides are 13. So in the case of rectangle, rectangle is a parallelogram. Why it is parallelogram? Because in the case of rectangle, the opposite sides are same. Is this side, it is same as this side. Here also this side will be same as opposite side. So this is the very important concept of rectangle. And opposite angle also same, because in the case of rectangles all angles make 90 degree, so all angles are same. So it match with the criteria of parallelogram. Each angle of rectangle is right angle because it is 90 degree. So rectangle is a parallelogram in which every angle is a right angle. So being a parallelogram, the rectangle has opposite side of equal length and the diagonal bisect each other. So being a parallelogram, the rectangle has opposite side. As I already told, opposite sides are same, opposite angles are same. So in parallelogram, the diagonal can be of different length, but in the rectangle, the diagonals are having same length. This is important point. So here we will see that property. The diagonals of rectangle are of equal length. This is very important property and we will prove that. So if you take this triangle, here that rectangle is divided into two triangles, we can divide that. So if you take ABC, this is one triangle, and ADB, this is one more triangle. So here we have to prove diagonal of rectangle are of equal length. So if you take this triangle, so how you will prove that this is ABC is a one triangle? So here I take the pen for explanation. So here ABC, this is nothing but that particular, and the second one is ADB. ADB means this part. So here we have to apply the property. So here in this triangle ABC and ABD separately, so here we have to take the two triangle as we are already taking. So here the measurement of BC and AD is same. So here if you see BC, and this angle is same because it is rectangle. And again if you observe there, this is the common side, so ultimately it will be same. Okay, here also it is given, then angle of A and B, as it is rectangles, their angle will be 90 degree. So here you observe there, these two angles are also same. So it means they are congruent angle, and because of that principle, AC equal to BD means this angle will be same, AC equal to BD. Sorry, these sides will be same. Why they are same? Because both are congruent. So it means this sides will be same. So it means that they are the indirectly diagonal. So they have the same length. So we prove that the diagonals of rectangle are of same length. Next one, if you take the example of rectangle, we have to find the value of x. Okay, here the measurement is given. Just now we have proved in the rectangle diagonals are same. So here the distance of this is 3x plus 1, here this distance is 2x plus 4. So here the diagonal meet at point O, and here the distance of OR is given. So this distance is given and the TO is also given. And one more important point is the diagonals are of same length. So here OT is the half of T and OR is the half of RN. And as we know, the diagonals are equal. So as the diagonals are equal, it means that 3x plus 1 can be written as it is equal to 2x plus 4. Because here they meet at point O. So this distance is already given. Up to this distance is already given. So they should be equal because their diagonals are same. That is very important point that we have discussed. And as these two sides are same, so we can easily calculate x equal to 3. Now in the case of squares, as you are familiar with the squares, all sides are same and they make the 90 angle, and there is a diagonals also, and that diagonals are also same. So square is a nothing but square can be a rectangle with equal side. This means square has all the properties of rectangle. How? Because opposite sides are same, angles are also same, diagonals are also same. Here you observe they bisect one another, and square, here it is given square about the diagonal bisect one another, and they are of equal length also, and they are perpendicular to one another also. So because of this property, the diagonal of square are the perpendicular bisector of each other. Okay, so for verifying the property, the diagonal of square are the perpendicular bisector means they are making the angle of 90 degree. So how we will prove that? In the ABCD of square, the diagonal meet at O. Okay, so OA is nothing but OC, since the square is a parallelogram also. Okay, because in this property we have to prove the diagonals of a square are the perpendicular bisector, means they should make the angle of 90 degree, and as we know square it is parallelogram, so they bisect each other. So OA equal to OC. So here we have to take two triangle like AOD and COD. If you take this, these two will be congruent because this side will be same, this is the common side. Here this side will be also same. Why it is same? Because here if you see in the square case all the sides are same, so this side is same as this one, so they are the congruent angle. So it means that AOD is COD, means these two angle will be also same, and they are linear angles, so they will cut into equal part, both will be 90 degree, so they are the right angle. So I hope friend you understood this presentation, and in the next class we will move on the exercise corner.